Welcome to the subcommittee of the Health and Human Services Committee. We have one bill on our agenda today, House Bill 520. It's for a hearing only. We're not voting on this bill today. Let me just remind you, we're going to limit individuals to 2 minutes just because we've got a long list of people signed up and we may not get to everybody today. And we'll get started. We're going to start with Rhonda Thomas. And when you step up to the mic, if you just identify yourself and if you represent yourself or someone else. Thank you. We'll let you know when your time's getting close.
Rhonda Thomas, I'm representing myself. So I have questions about conflict of interest within the bill. Public-private partnerships have historically been financial gain for the lead agency, the nonprofits, and perhaps the executive committees to the detriment of the stakeholders. These have been employed by various HHS and Georgia State Health agencies since the 70s. They are controlled by those who give grants and private foundations and who give money or corporate sponsors. They eliminate accountability with the general public. There's also a conflict of interest when it comes to a lot of the organizations involved because they're backed by psychopharma. These are just a few, but not all of them. American Foundation of Suicide Prevention, Anxiety Disorders, Attention Deficit Disorder, Center of the Advancement of Children's Mental Health, Children and Adults with ADD, the list goes on and on. There's another, public-private partnerships have a tendency to grossly disproportionately benefit the lead host agency. We've talked about that. Health benefit plan shall not impose, on line 76, health benefit plan shall not impose a step therapy protocol for a prescription drug prescribed for the treatment of serious mental illness as defined by the department. Which prescription drugs? There is a sound reason to not automatically prescribe pharmaceuticals rather than using other therapeutic modalities. Sorry, I'm nervous. This needs to be more specific if it's kept at all. Line 157 to 159, validated screening and best practices. The pharmaceutical corps have spent large amounts of researching, money on researching the development of subtle psychological screening tools, which will result in health behavioral health diagnosis. These are usually created by pharmaceutical for physicians that are not qualified to read or certified, such as psychologists and psychiatrists. And 78 to 80%
of the time, they lead to a diagnosis that requires pharmaceutical and mental illness. Is that my 2 minutes?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
What's going on with mine?
That would have been interesting.
Thank you.